Here's your host, Alex Garrett.
These little town blues, are melting away. I'm gonna make a brand new start of it. Up to you, New York, New York, New York.
Indeed, Frank Sinatra, it is up to us here in New York, New York, and I have been very excited to jump on today. I wasn't really going to do something without a guest, but you know what? There's so much information that's still coming out on in the city that I want you to know about and ways you can help. So please stay with me for the next few minutes. Alex Garrett here. It's this version of the Saturday Sit Down. May not have a guest, but I've got a lot of resources to continue to tell you about New York and nationwide, because we have seen people stepping up day in and day out in the city, in the nation, to provide masks and to help hospitals and to just keep things moving for the healthcare workers that are doing what they can day in and day not and day out. I know I've told you my story of how the nurses at the NICU at St. Luke's Roosevelt spent 70-plus days working on me to keep me healthy and the other ICU NICU babies as well healthy and to keep them alive and around and alive and kicking. Well, that's the heart of where I feel so much appreciation for what today's nurses are doing in the ICUs, in the NICUs, in the hospitals, because I've been there. My mom's been there. We've all in this family been there dealing with that. And so I would have to imagine the appreciation escalates even more when you see the hard work, when you see that they're not taking their time off, when you see that they cannot stay home. They have to go in and be around these situations and these health threats to make other people safer. I mean, those people, those nurses, those doctors deserve so much applause, so much credit, so much accolades and more. And now they also need the supplies. And so when I saw this in the story today, in the city today, thanks to my mom, actually, for forwarding this one to me. When I saw this in the city today, and as you know, I've had, actually, Jose Martinez from the city, city.nyc, I thought, let me talk to you about this. There are still ways where people can donate. Do you want to know how? Call 646-522. This is from the governor's office, Governor Andrew Cuomo, who has taken the lead every step of the way here. So let me give you this number, 646-522-8477, or email covid19supplies@esd.ny.gov. You want to help? You want to help get us through this crisis? We can. We're New Yorkers. We're strong as ever. Here's your opportunity, 646-522-8477, or covid19supplies@esd.ny.gov. Christian Soriano has been helping make these masks as well. We're ordering now, according to the governor today, who have put 100% stay-at-home mandate to those who don't need to be, non-essentials. I'll get to that in a minute as well. Because we're all essential at the end of the day. That's why our lives matter, because we're essential, each and every one of us. Even if our job is quote-unquote non-essential compared to EMS, compared to FDNY, compared to NYPD, compared to the hospitals, compared to the nurses, we are all essential. That's why we need to heed the calls of this governor to stay in if we can do so. There are 1 million masks heading to New York City, just as 10,000 cases are now announced here in New York. New York City Health and Hospitals, which manages the city's public hospital network. All this information coming from Rachel Holiday Smith of the city.nyc, at Rachel Holiday. You can follow her. They're looking for help, too. And that website is nychc.networkforgood.com. You can donate right there, 10, 25, 50. Look, you may be staying in to quarantine yourself. You may be heeding the call. You may be abiding by the mandate. But that doesn't mean you can't help from afar. And so, nychc.networkforgood.com. Or New Yorkers rolling up their sleeves. I love it. Flatbush Raid designer Kirby Jean Raymond of Pyre Moss has now turned his West 27th Street studio into a collection point for masks and other equipment. That's Kirby Jean Raymond of Pyre Moss is just becoming a donation center. You should check them out, West 27th, Google Pyre Moss. For more information with him, contact wanttohelp@yourfriendsin.nyc. wanttohelp@yourfriendsin.nyc. And spelling on that, by the way, is P-Y-E-R Moss. That's P-Y-E-R-M-O-S-S. And again, that's wanttohelp@yourfriendsin.nyc. This whole crisis has really taught me that this could be more of an information vessel, because you may not be getting the information. You may not have time to look through all this resources that are going on. Luckily, I've got family. I've got friends that are emailing me constantly. Hey, here's ways people are helping. I got 692-692, which you should do as well. Notify NYC on my phone. Get it on your phone too. 692-692. That are telling you, hey, go to, if you feel like you're being scammed during this COVID-19, that's a thing as well. If you feel like you're being scammed, go to nyc.gov/DWCP to avoid COVID-19 scams. Isn't that crazy? In a time of crisis, people continue to use that in evil ways to get you to donate to something that doesn't exist. So don't even think about picking up a call that isn't really official CDC or any health organization's real officials there. Big thanks to Echo Health Alliance, who donated hundreds of brand new gloves, Tyvek suits, and N95 masks. So, and if you know of other ways to donate supplies, don't be afraid to email coronavirus@thecity.nyc. That's coronavirus@thecity.nyc. NYC. Thank you to them for this coverage day in and day out. I get their reports too, but this one, when I saw it in my inbox, I said, I had to jump on this and talk to you about it. And I really don't care if I'm doing it every day. I used to wonder if I should do this podcast every day. Well, here's a time where you can use information on the daily. So here's some more information. I'll run down all the websites and emails and numbers once again for you if I went too fast the first time. Contact 646-522-8477, 646-522-8477. If you want to connect donors, if you want to be a donor to those who need equipment, or email COVID-19 supplies@esd.ny.gov. Follow, of course, NYGov Cuomo on Twitter for more information. New York City Health and Hospitals also looking for help. According to their spokeswoman Stephanie Guzman, nychc.networkforgood.com. That's nychc.networkforgood.com. New York City Health and Hospitals. Pyre Moss, wanttohelp@yourfriendsin.nyc. That's wanttohelp@yourfriendsin.nyc. West 27th, 7th floor is where they're doing a donation point. I mean, this company's emptying out their studios to do donations during this time. New Yorkers are coming together. We just have to soak in that information. We have to find the information. And of course, if you have more information for the city, find out, email them at coronavirus at thecity.nyc. And thanks again to Echo Health Alliance for their contribution to this, donations. And again, an update of the latest. Not only are we 100% mandate to stay in if we don't have to be in, Cuomo saying now that 1 million masks are heading to New York City as we really are working to combat the spread of coronavirus, COVID-19. During this time, it seems like, based on the information I'm reading, that we're coming together. Then I looked at the nationwide help. Well, let's first thank MDH Construction in Plymouth, Massachusetts, to donate 400 respirators to Beth Israel Deaconess Hospital in Plymouth, Mass. On Wednesday. In Maryland, we've got people coming together where boat dealership donated 14,095 respirator masks and that they've actually kept in their storage. Rick Levin of this dealership said that he was originally buying the masks to donate to children undergoing chemotherapy. That has also been now allotted to those fighting coronavirus. So, Massachusetts, Maryland, statewide, we're seeing an effort to come together. And I hope that is where we turn the corner as a country. I hope that all this coming together doesn't stop once we've fought the spread. I hope that we can make it last longer than a day, or we're all saying we can help each other. Maybe now's the time to stop videoing people being hit and start to step in and say, yeah, you cannot hit this person anymore. Like on World's Hard Hip Hop, maybe that can be the end of that. Maybe we can see the end of political arguments constantly on Facebook. And yeah, I'm at fault for that too. But maybe we can all just pitch in a little more every day. And maybe this virus, as awful as it is, can teach us that we can unite. We have the power. We're United States of America for a reason. And the fact that New York is the epicenter, as Mayor de Blasio has said, is wild to think about. I mean, this is a city of 8 million people. And to now have 10,000 cases statewide, 6211 in New York, 1,800 in the last 24 hours since Friday. This epicenter cannot fall apart. We have to come together and say we're going to wipe this out on behalf of the city, on behalf of the country. City.nyc is showing us ways to do it. Other organizations are as well. Google if you want to help out. Donate if you want to help out. 692-692 tells you ways you can help out. Notify NYC. Just do it. Because if we don't, this disaster will keep going for months on end, and we don't want that. And if you are an essential, quote-unquote essential employee, please be safe. I have to be, and so I'll be washing my hands. I'll be sanitizing everything, even my crutches. Because that's just what you got to do in a time of this magnitude, this time of need to be safe and clean. And that's the other thing. I hope after this, people continue to wash their hands. I hope they continue to be as clean as they can. Because as, after all, germs, as bad as coronavirus, germs exist no matter what. So maybe it's time to learn a lesson in hygiene. Huh? So we'll see. But yes, New York, the city, the state is truly, as Dion says, calling us to step up. And those of you who heeded the call, great. Let's inspire more to do so individually, company-wise, listening to the mandate of 100% stay home if they aren't essential to the business operations and to the company that is essential to New York. I'm sure we'll hear a lot about that in the days to come, what's essential, what's non-essential. But right now, grocery stores, pharmacies, banks will be open. They are essential, of course, EMS, FDNY, NYPD, all essential. Nurses, again, thank you for doing what you do day in and day, tirelessly, hours on end, midnight through whenever, to keep New Yorkers that have it comfortable and safe, and to try and treat them as you're protecting yourself, doctors as well. But yes, this weekend, it's important to know that once again, New York is calling all of us to do our part. Are we ready? Are you ready? Can we make this an effort to put everyone ahead of us, if you will, or put each other ahead of each other? Like, don't just say me. Put us all together and help us heal, not just through this, but through everything. We're New York. We can come together. We've sadly had to do this before, and that memory is scarred in all of us. 9/11. And we were united then. And unfortunately, that unity didn't last, I feel, more than a couple years. So let's make this unity. Let's make this disaster last the rest of our lives. Because I think we're all tired of bickering and battling and commenting and posting and fighting and really not looking at each other as the people we are. Just working to make things work in the city. Even without COVID-19, we've been working to make things work in the city. Let's work a little bit harder to help each other make things work in the city. Let's heed the call as Dion and one of my favorites, Paul Simon, a Queens College graduate, sang in one of their newest songs, New York Is My Home. Yes, indeed, New York is calling all of us. Have a safe Saturday. We'll talk to you soon.
New York is calling me, and now I find the city never sleeps. It's my state of mind.